Hey guys, what's up? I am Vikash for Pixartor and welcome to this brand new video. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create this awesome looking poster inside of Photoshop. So let's jump into the Photoshop and get started. Alright, so here we are in Photoshop and let's import our main image that we are going to use in this project. So just go to File and click on Open. And in this case, I'm going to use this image that I have downloaded from unsplash.com, and I will provide a link in the description. So just go to the link and download this image if you want and click on Open. And now I'm going to crop this image. So select this crop tool, and in this case I'm going to use this 4:5 ratio, and I'm going to crop this image just like that. And for better result, we need an image with plain background, something like this. But in this case, we have some unwanted disturbing element on this image. So what we have to do, select this quick selection tool and create a selection just like that, and hold Alt on the keyboard and just subtract this area and make it a proper selection, and take a new layer and pick this color from here, hit OK, hit Alt and hit Backspace on the keyboard to fill this selected color on this selection, and hit Control D for deselection. And now I'm going to erase these edges. So select this erase tool, set this opacity to 100%, flow 100%, and select this soft brush and just drag it over here and blend it like this. Now it's looking much more better. And do the same thing for this one. So select this quick selection tool, select this image layer, just draw a selection over here, hold Alt on the keyboard to subtract, and let's subtract this area just like this. And now do the same thing. So select this a new layer, hold Alt on the keyboard, hit Backspace to fill this foreground color into this selection, hit Control D for deselect. And now let's erase this edges. So select this erase tool and just drag it like this. And now we have to merge this layer. So select these both layer, hit Control E to merge, and click on this lock icon and unlock this image, and just double click on that and call it image. Now I'm going to convert this image into a single color tone image. So what we have to do, just select this move tool and click on this adjustment layer icon over here and add a gradient map effect, and single click on this gradient map. And inside of this gradient editor, this section belongs to the darkest part of the image and this section belongs to the brighter part of the image. So for the brighter part, I'm going to pick this cyan color like this, hit OK. And for the darkest part, I'm going to pick this black color, hit OK. And just double click on that and call it cyan. Create a group of these layers. So select this image and this adjustment layer, hit Control G to create a group, double click on that, call it cyan. And now let's import our another image. So just go to your folder, and in this case I'm going to use this outdoor image. So just drag it on this Photoshop and fit this image like this, hit enter. And now do the same thing for this image. So double click on that, call it busy for background, and make it a single color tone image. So click on this adjustment layer icon, click on this gradient map, and single click on this gradient map, and pick this pure black color, hit OK. And for the brighter part, I'm gonna pick this red color, hit OK. And now we have this type of image, and select this gradient ramp, double click on that, call it red, and select this red adjustment layer and background image, and hit Control Z to create a group, double click on that, call it red. And now select this red layer and change this to a screen mode. And now we get this type of output, as you can see. And after that, I'm going to remove this red section from this face. So what we have to do, we have to create a layer mask for this red layer. So click on this layer mask icon and add a layer mask on this red group. And now let's paint black color on this section to remove this red color. So just select this paint tool and set this opacity 50%, flow 50%. Select a soft brush and just erase it like this. And after that, we have to do some color adjustment with this. So click on this adjustment layer icon and add a brightness and contrast effect. And let's increase this contrast value something around 70 maybe. And let's down this brightness negative 20. And now it's looking much more interesting, as you can see. And after that, we have to add a text over here. So select this text tool. And for the text, I'm gonna use this Century Gothic font style and set it to bold. And for the text size, I'm gonna set this 500 pixel maybe. Click over here and type anything that you want. So I'm gonna type drag, hit Control A to highlight all, and pick this pure white color and click over here, hit enter, and just set it to vertical and hit Control A to highlight all and go to this character. If you can't see this character option, then go to window and check this option character. All right, and I'm gonna set this line spacing something around 500 pixel. All right, and now let's align it to the center. Just like that. And let's add one more text over here. So just click on this text tool and click over here and type your second line. Hit Control A to highlight all. And for this one, I'm gonna use this Go Bold font style and just set it to vertical. Hit Control A to highlight all and let's down the size a bit. So I'm gonna set this size 150 pixel maybe, and I'm gonna set this line spacing auto. And now just drag this text right over here. Select this text tool again, click over here, hit Control A to highlight all and pick this pure black color for now, hit OK. And after that, let's create a rectangular shape around the text. So select this rectangle tool and click on this stroke and set it to none. And click on this field, set it to solid color and pick this pure white color. And let's drag over here and create a rectangular shape just like that. And now just drag this rectangle layer below this text layer. And now let's do some setting. So select this rectangle, click on this property icon and just go to this property. And here, let's set this width value something around 120 pixel and height 1150 maybe. All right. And now select this rectangle layer and this text layer and select this move tool and go over here and click on this align vertically and click on this align horizontally and basically set this text in the center of this rectangular shape. And after that, select this rectangle, click on this layer mask and hold Control on the keyboard and click on this T icon and make a selection around this text and select this layer mask, pick this pure black color, hold Alt on the keyboard, hit backspace and fill this black color and turn off the visibility of this text layer and hit Control D to deselect. And now let's align this shape layer properly. Now it's looking much more interesting. And that's all for this tutorial, guys. I hope you like it. If you like it, then hit the subscribe button and click on the bell icon to get notified when I will upload my new video. And I will see you in next tutorial. Till then, bye-bye.